Thanks, John. Next, I'd like to call on Leanne Rodriguez of the Conservation Trust of Puerto Rico.
Good morning. My name is Leanne Rodriguez. I work at the Conservation Trust of Puerto Rico at a newly created unit called Para la Naturaleza, and our mission is to secure land of great ecological value. And we have a very ambitious goal of protecting 33% of our land by the year 2033. We know that to achieve that goal, we have to create alliances, collaborations, but most of all, we have to engage the public. And that's where citizen science comes in for us. Around 5 years ago, we were granted an award by the National Science Foundation, and we had our great team represented here today by our champions, Sandra Faria and Astrid Maldonado, who recruited more than 2,500 individuals of all walks of life, all ages, to come in and participate in over 600 hands-on STEM and nature-related activities. And they gave us more than 25,000 hours of their time. And we had a great retention rate. We had more than 1,000 people come in time over time to contribute to our project. And our champion citizen science is sitting here in the back row. His name is Willy Burgos. And he contributed to our project something that we had not planned, that we had not foreseen. He created and designed the first field guide on land crabs for Puerto Rico with the researcher. And on his own, he went and created a guidebook, an illustrated guidebook, of all the crabs that we have in Puerto Rico. That was not even in our outcomes or deliverables in our planned things. So we were like, wow, that's really cool. How can we continue to create citizen science like Willy? So now we are purposely assessing our process, the experience the researchers and the participants go through, to see if we can build a model that we can replicate that experience. In my opinion, there are certain factors that come to play for that. For instance, citizen science has given our organization the opportunity to be inclusive, to be open-minded and flexible, and to be synergistic. And to us, it's a no-brainer. Now we're applying citizen science across the board in all of our programs. For instance, we are using it in a project for the reintroduction of an endangered species, which is funded by the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service. We are using it for a champing of tree competition funded by the Forest Service. We are using it for eBird. Thank you, John. We are also using it for our community outreach and beach cleanup projects funded by NIFWIF. And we have the private sector also supporting us. We have Pfizer Pharmaceuticals and AT&T helping us in our program, Map of Life Landscape Inventory Program. So we've been able to apply citizen science across the board. And to us, citizen science means connections. It has helped us to connect people to one another, people to science, most of all, people to nature. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Leah.